Hello guys, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. Today we are going to talk about bed plate, different type of construction of bed plate and how the bed plate components are divided and how they are attached and what are the support which are provided in bed plate. So that all topic we are going to cover today. So let's begin the video. Welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. So today, as I have told you, we are going to talk about bed plate. So what is a bed plate? So bed plate is a foundation on which the engine is built. Means what do I mean by that? That the engine foundation is been provided by the bed plate on which whole engine is been installed. Okay. Bed plate should be able to flex along with the hull of the ship. What do I mean by that? Means it should be such that it can be able to take the hogging and sagging motion which is caused by the wave during the ship movement. Means bed plate structure should be such that it can be able to flex along with the hull structure. Otherwise, if the structure is too stiffened, in that case it may break down. To prevent that, we are making the bed plate in such a way that it can be able to flex. Okay. Now let's see what is the function of bed plate. The function of bed plate is be such that it should be able to support the weight of the engine. What do I mean by that? That support the weight of the engine means the whole engine is being placed on the bed plate, so it should be able to support the weight of the engine. It should also maintain the crankshaft alignment. How the crankshaft alignment is maintained? As you can see, this form the part where the main beam general support is being provided, and okay, so and crankshaft pass through this main beam general, so the alignment is also been maintained by the bed plate. If the bed plate is even, in that case the crankshaft alignment will also be correct. It also resists the torque coupled force from the propeller which try to rotate the engine around the crankshaft. This I mean by the torsional vibration or torsional torque which occur because of the couple movement. Okay. So now we will see what are the component of bed plate. So first, before seeing the component, let's see what material we are using. We are using 0.23% of the carbon steel. As you can see, the percentage of carbon is less, because if the carbon percentage increases, it means it will get brittle. But carbon is also needed so that it have an inherent vibration absorbent property. Okay, and steel, as you can see, it is resistant to the rust, oxidation, and it also provide higher strength. Okay. Now, as you can see, what are the component of bed plate? So let's see. This is called longitudinal girder. Okay, this is called longitudinal girder, and this is the transverse girder. On this, the crankshaft is been placed, and this part form the main bearing area of the crankshaft, where the bottom end bearing and top bearing of the main bearing is housing is been placed, and the crankshaft pass through this. Okay. This is called transverse girder. This whole part is called transverse girder. Okay. And as you can see, various stiffening member like these are provided so that to help to enhance the strength, to provide strength to withstand the hogging and sagging motion, as well as the weight of the engine. This stiffening member is been provided. Now, as you can see, this is the double bottom. Okay, this double bottom is provided so that to able to take the weight of the engine, and this double bottom structure is also supported with the solid plate floor. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the different type of bed plate. So this is the first type, which is called trestle type bed plate. Okay, as you can see, this is the mounting on which the whole bed plate is been placed. Okay, means there is not separate any double bottom structure is provided. The whole bed plate is been supported on this elevated sitting. Okay, as you can see in this diagram. Okay, so same thing I have written here, elevated sitting, as the bed plate is bolted to the tank top. So this is the tank top on which the elevated sitting, the bed plate is been attached through bolt. Okay. So basically, this type of arrangement is been provided in a medium speed engine or in a low power vessel, because in that case the weight of the bit plate is not so much, okay, and weight of the engine is not so much, and this arrangement has an advantage that it, if there is any damage to the casting plate, then the whole thing, this whole thing can be replaced and installed easily without having much financial loss. So same thing I have written here, more useful and less financial loss occur if the cast plate turn out to be defective. Why? Because it may happen that the cast plate may get damaged due to grounding, or it may happen that the cast plate may damage because of rust and because of some mishap. In that case, we don't need to change the whole bed plate, because as a bed plate is in place in an elevated seating, this seating arrangement can be replaced and hence the financial loss will be less to the company. Now here we come to a second type, which is called box type bed plate. Okay, so what is box type bed plate? Basically, this name is been come for because of its shape like a box. Okay, this is a longitudinal girder, this is the transverse girder. Okay, so box type bed plate is fabricated and then welded and then stress relief. Means what do I mean by that? That each component of longitudinal girder, transverse girder are made separately by forging method, and then they are placed together by the help of the welding. So same thing I have written here, longitudinal girder single plate construction with stiffening web help to reduce the weight and overall width of the engine, eliminating the problem of cracking also. So what do I mean by that? That this longitudinal girder is made up of single plate construction with the help of the stiffening member. This stiffening member is provided, which also reduces the weight of the engine. Means the single plate construction of the longitudinal girder eliminate the weight and hence also reduces the cost, okay, and different problem like cracking also. Now this transverse girder is made up of cast steel, okay, and the bearing pocket are deeply placed. Why? Because so that the shaft center can be lowered, causing the horizontal force to be absorbed into it. So what do I mean by that? That the this transverse girder is mirroring journal is made deep cut so that the overall central line or overall central line is been reduced to lower one, and which causing the horizontal force to be absorbed directly into it. Okay, now here as you can see that this is the transverse girder. Okay, this part you can see here is this. Okay, this is a transverse girder, and this is, as you can see, this is the tie bolt hole, and this is the where the bearing is going to be mounted. This is being just come out from the forging method, and after that it will be stress relief, and then it will be welded and again stress relief. Okay, and this is, as you can see, this is the transverse girder with having top keep of the main bearing. Okay, and this is the fully assembled part of the bed plate. So in this diagram I am going to show you the support which is been provided on the bottom of the bed plate. As you can see, this is the top part of the bed plate, and this is the double bottom structure with solid plate floor is provided so that the bed plate can withstand the whole weight of the engine. Okay, the double bottom under the bed plate is provided with the additional stiffening member. Solid plate floor at the every frame is provided. Foundation plate is much more thicker than the other. So as you can see, this is the foundation plate, this is the foundation plate, and this is the bed plate. Okay, and this is the double bottom support which we need to provide so that this bed plate, as it will take the weight of the whole engine, can be able to withstand the weight. For that, the foundation plate which is provided here is thicker than the other area which is where the machinery or other machinery are installed. Okay, like as you can see, this is the tank top and this is the bed plate, and this is a double bottom structure which is being support is provided, and this foundation plate is thickened. So for supporting purpose, double bottom structure beneath the bed plate is additionally stiffened. That's what I mean to say. Okay, I hope you understand, and please do like and subscribe my video, and please share. थैंक यू फ्रेंड, प्लीज़ हैव अ गुड इवनिंग।